today I will conduct this meeting, this online meeting to show the financial performance of our company. So let's take a look for the cash flow, for our cash flow. Okay. As you can see, in this liquidity ratio, for the first one is current ratio. So the current ratio for the previous year is 3.05 and for the current year is 2.76. So it means that our company is in a bad performance. Next, the second one is quick ratio. The last year is 1.99 times and for the current year is 1.93 times, which is lower than the previous year. Next, day to sell inventory. For the last year is 36 days and for the current year is 39 days. Next, average collection period. Average collection period for the previous year is 15 days and for the current year is 32 days, which means that our time to collect the sales from the customer take a long time. The last one, the liquidity ratio is net working capital, which is for the last year is RM544,055 and for the current year is 715,000. So the next one is in the efficient ratio, account receivable turnover is known as the for the current year is 18 times, but the previous year is 24.46 times. Next is inventory turnover. For the current year is 9.27 times, and for the previous year is 10.07 times. Next is fixed asset turnover for the previous year is 4.98 times and for the current year is 5.88 times. That show that increase from the previous year. Next is total asset turnover. It show that our company has a 3.44 times for the current year and for the last year is 3.32 times. Next is our leverage or solvency ratio. It show that the debt ratio for our company is decreased from the last year, which means it's good for our company. That is, for the last year is 47.56%, but for this year is 46%. Next, debt to equity ratio. Debt to equity ratio also decreased from 0.91 times for the previous year. Net ratio in the previous year is 0.66 times and for the current year is 0.57 times. And net is the time interest earned, which is also low from the previous year. That is from the previous year is 22.63 times and the current year is 90.33 times. So the last one for our ratio is profitability ratio. As we can see in this, the gross profit margin is increased from the previous year, which means good for our company. That is 65%. Meanwhile, the previous year is 93.33%. Next, operating profit margin. But this operating profit margin decreased from the previous year. That is only 36.25%, but the previous year is 36.16%. Next is net profit margin. Net profit margin also decreased. That's only 24.06%. Meanwhile, in the previous year is 24.86%. The next one is return on asset. Return on asset at the same time is 0.3 times. and net is written on EPP, which are lower than the previous year, which are the previous year is 1.67 at 167.48 times. Meanwhile, for the current year is 155.30 times. And the last one is written on EPP, also known as a dew point, which are increased from the previous year. There is 36.0 times. Meanwhile, the previous year is 39.15 times. Okay, that's all from me for the cash flow. So next, I will pass to the next presenter.
Okay, today I want to share or explain with you the comparative financial statement analysis, index trend number analysis, common size analysis. First of all, we want to look at the difference current year and previous year. So we have the information here, and regarding to the financial position of company for 3 years. That means year-to-year changes. We look back for the 2 years, which is 2020 and 2019. For example, cash, compare the difference cash 2020 and 2019. So the total difference is negative 15,000. And for this also is the same method from 2019 and 2018. For the percentage in year 2020, the total difference on 2020 with 2019 divided by cash in 2019 times hundreds. For the financial performance, also same method. For the explanation, we can see the total current asset increased 38.49% as compared to the total current liability by 53.02%, thus resulting current ratio also decreased. That means company has better liquidity in 2019 as compared to the year 2020. After we calculate net profit margin, the result is increased from year to year, and the net income decreased by 29.05% as compared 171.53% in 2019, resulting net profit margin increase. Next, for the index trend number analysis. First thing first, we need to ensure the basis in the last year, which is 2019, is 100, and the last year is always 100%. To calculate the index year 2020, for example, we use cash year 2020 divide by cash base year 2018. And time 100%. So index always ups and down, as you can see on total asset, which is increased amount from 2018 till 2020. For further explanation, the total current asset increased to 284.83% in 2020 from base year 100%. The total current liability increased to 244.75% from base year 100%. So current asset increase and current liability increase, thus current ratio decrease as compared with 2019. For the net income and or EAT, both year of 2020 and 2019 also increase in the index from base year. Index increase in 2020 is higher than index increased in 2019, resulting net profit margin company also increased. We move to the next analysis. Common size analysis. For example, we want to look at the percentage of analysis. For example, in year 2020, the cash 2020 divided by total asset in 2020 times 100. So that means cash in 2020 is 3.05% from total asset. For the liability and equity also, in the same way, moreover, the total asset and total liability and equity always 100%. For the financial performance, sales always 100%. Other example, cost of goods sold divided by sale times 100. For the explanation, as you can see on the template, total current asset and total current liability in 2020 and 2019 become increased from year to year. That means increase in current asset is higher than percentage increase in current liability, thus resulting decrease in current ratio. For the cost of goods sold decreased from 36.67% of sale in 2019 to 35% of sale in 2020, resulting in gross profit margin from 63.33% 2019 to 65% in 2020. That's all. I will pass to the next presenter.
Okay, now we will take a look to the statement of the cash flow. So, first, we will take a look at the operating activity. As you can see, the operating activities include current asset and current liabilities. Okay, for the operating activities, as you can see here, for 2020, we will compare with 2019. So for the current asset, for 2020, we can see that mostly the amount is higher than 2019. So when we compare, we can see that most of the current asset is outflow. So for current liabilities, it's also the same, which is 2020 is higher than 2019, and it create inflow of money for the company. Okay, now we will move to the investing activities. So for investing activity, as you can see, it's also the inflow of money from the company, and we made an adjustment for the net in which is total negative 530,000, and it is also an inflow of money for the company. Okay, next we will move to the financing activity. You can see outflow on him. This is the investment activity from the company. And for the adjustment for cash dividend, for the dividend paid is 1,704,800. Okay, now take a look at the statement here. For the net cash from operating activity, the total is 1,971,555, and the net cash investing activity is negative 512,500. And the net cash from financing activity is 1,474,055. And the total net cash for the company ended 2020 is negative 15,000. And based on the statement cash of flow, we can see that the operating activity of PKPB the company is doing quite good. Okay, next, if you see the net cash from investing activity, we can see that the company only made a short-term investment for our operation. And okay, from financing activity, you can see that mostly it come from cash flow that resulting from the term loan and the obligation that related to capital. So, the company also have a cash dividend, which is negative 1,700,800. And as a conclusion, that you can see that the company is operating the whole activity based on operating activities only.
Thank you, Ms. Aina, for the explanation. But me, as the shareholder, I would like to know, in your perspective, what did you guys see in this company performance in long term for the 10 years in future?
Okay, thank you, Ms. Hana. Okay, so 10 years from now, we can guarantee you that your investment will be worth it. Because why? If you look at the cash flow statement, you can see that the debt is decreasing in 2020 compared to last year. And to make it more secure, that we currently are trying to decrease our debt, and we will increase our equity in our company. So we can guarantee you that you can invest in our company.
All right, Ms. Aina, I understand. Another question, I would like to know that why did you think that your company can give the benefit for me as the shareholder to invest in your company?
For the second question, the company can give benefit to their shareholder by two main ways, by paying dividend or by buying back share of stock.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Hana, for the questions, and for Ms. Aina and Ms. Arifa for answer the question from Ms. Hana. Okay, any questions? Okay, no. So I will end this online meeting for today, and I hope we can see each other for another online meeting. Okay, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.